Well, those little bugs flying around your kitchens, it seems to happen late summer into fall. Fruit flies, drain flies, there's a whole host of different little things that are buzzing around, but those are probably the two biggest ones, and there is a little bit of difference in the two. The fruit flies, obviously, by the name, are going after rotting fruit, tomatoes, all those different things that we're bringing in from our garden. But the thing is, and drain flies generally are breeding inside the drain, and sometimes they're called sewage flies. But here's the where the crossover is. The fruit fly sometimes breeds in the drain as well. So there's some things you can do. There's certainly like little traps that you can do. This is a commercial fruit fly trap. It's the number one selling trap in the country. It says it right there on the package. Must be good. All right, so it's got a little bait in there, and you just put it in, and they work like crazy because they will draw all of those little fruit flies into that little apple because they think it's an apple. So you can also do a little do-it-yourselfer. This is a wine. Looks like white wine. So this is a wine glass. And if you take some apple cider vinegar, you just pour it in, and when you pull it over the top, pop some holes in it, and same thing, they're attracted to that, the sweetness, and you'll see them floating in there. And that's all fine and dandy, but if you're not getting to the point where you're figuring out where they're breeding, you're gonna have problems, because these things can hatch like 500 eggs in, I think, in a week period. So you've got to figure out where is that again, and keep everything clean, get rid of the rotting, the food and different things. So that's the obvious ones, but sometimes it's in the cabinets where a potato has fallen off of a rack or something like that, and they are breeding, and that is the breeding ground. So important in this little fly management is figuring out where. So on the drains, what you can do is if you would just cover over the drains and then with some pop some holes in there, leave it overnight, and you'll kind of see what's stuck to the bottom of it. Tomorrow morning you'll find out if they're breeding in there. Now if it is a sewer or a drain fly, if you smash one and they're kind of sooty, that's a drain fly. And in that case, then you want to make sure you treat all the drains all over the house. Fruit flies, but it's the same thing. If you would get rid of, you can take a, this is good for your drainage anyways, you should be doing this, but this is drain defense. This is not a drain opener. What it does, it eats the organic matter that builds up inside of drains. So a couple scoops, stir that up. A nice little liquid, and here you come, fruit fly. It's coming for you. So you would treat that, and this is not a bad thing to do once a month, again, just for your drain health, but that'll help keep the drains clean, because if that is breeding down there, that's the problem. But looking for those other spots, you know, that's so important. And the other thing that you can get, these are the other things, those little pantry, the little moss. So this is a little trap that you can sit inside the pantry. Same thing, you gotta watch the grain, the flour, all of that. So prevention is key when you're trapping these little boogers. All right, have a good day.